Dear students, again we continue. This is the third video for experiment 8, that is Banker algorithm. So we were discussing about here. We were somewhere here in the this one. If a process is not equal to minus 1, then process percentage runs to completion. Process plus 1. So that particular process will be running for completion. Then safe sequence of count equal to process plus 1, number of process plus 1, that will be safe sequence. We'll put that process in the matrix in the array safe sequence. And count plus plus for j equal to 0, j less than r, j plus plus, and available of j will be equal to that allocation of process j plus available of j, and allocation of process j will make it 0, and maximum of process and j will make it 0, and completed of process will also 1, and this will be, this algorithm will be running till all the process count is not equal to p and process is not equal to minus. So this algorithm will keep running. It will keep running. If count equal to p, then we'll check it out. If count equal to p, we say the system is in the safe state. And safe sequence we can display from the safe sequence. Here safe sequence array, safe sequence array. Else, if count is not equal to p, then we can display that the system is in the and unsafe state. For example, let us see here. I have tapped this program in one online compiler called onlinegdb.com, and I have written the processor C language one. So you see that the same program which I explained you, same program I have tapped here, and let me see. Let me run this program. You can see that it is running. There is no error, no warning. So here enter the number of process. Number of process will enter is 4. Then enter the number of resources. Number of resources we had 3, A, B, C. We will enter 3. Then enter the maximum matrix for each process. So for process 1, it is 7, 5, 3, 7, 5, 5, 3. Then enter the for process 2, it is a 3, 2, 2, 3, 2, 2. For process 3, it is a 9. 0, 2. For process 4, it is 2, 2, 2. Enter the allocation for each process. It is allocation matrix we put 0, 1, 0, then 2, 0, 0, 3, 0, 2, 2, 1, 1. And enter the available resources. Number of resources available will enter 10, 5, and 7. Will you see? Yes. So it is showing that maximum matrix 7, 5, 3 allocation matrix it is given. Process 1 runs to completion. then maximum matrix will become like that. When process 1 run, then maximum will be 0 and this will be yes. Here you can check that it need matrix 7 4 and 3, it is less than available, so it will be first P1 will be satisfied, then P2, P3 and P4 will be satisfied, and that system will be called in the safe state. This is how the program will run, and when P1 is completed, then P2 will be checked out, it will be complete, then P3 and P4 will be completed. We can run one more. Let us run one more time. Enter the number of processes. This time we will enter 5. Enter the number of resources. We will enter 3. Then enter the maximum matrix for process 1. We will enter 7, 5, 3. Then 3, 2, 2. Then 9 0 2, then 4 2 2 2, then 4 3 3, then enter the number of each for process. Enter the allocation for process 0 1 0 2 0 0, then 3 0 2, then 2 1 1 0 0 2. Enter the number of resources, same thing, 10 5 and 7. So let us, this is also in safe state, and it is in for the safe sequence is 1 2 3 4 5 is number. So this is how it works. Okay, thank you very much. The next program, that is program number 9, will be seen in the next lecture video. Thank you.